a pensioner in Denmark. He has begun a legal battle to be recognized as being 20 years younger than his actual age so he can go back to work and achieve greater success with women on Tinder. His name is Emil Radelbein. He is 69. He argues that if transgender people are allowed to change sex, he should be allowed to change his date of birth because doctors said he has the body of a 45-year-old. This guy, not all heroes wear capes. I mean, just spectacular. So the entrepreneur and self-help guru is suing his local authority after they refused to amend his age on official documents. His case has now gone to a court in the eastern Dutch province of Gelderland. The case has caused controversy in his homeland, where the Dutch edition of Vice, a news website, asked, is Emil Radelbein disturbed or accidentally extremely woke? And that would be the question, right? Because they are the same thing, being extremely woke and being disturbed. Now the crossover, like if you had a Venn diagram of extremely woke and disturbed, the Venn diagram is just a circle. Okay, Mr. Radelbein was born on March 11, 1949. He says he feels at least 20 years younger. He wants to change his birth date to March 11th, 1969. He says, I've done the checkup. What does it show? My biological age is 45 years. When I'm 69, I'm limited. If I'm 49, I can buy a new house, drive a different car. I can take up more work. When I'm on Tinder and I say I'm 69, I don't get an answer. When I'm 49, with the face I have, I will be in a luxurious position. So transgenders can now have their gender changed on their birth certificate. And in the same spirit, there should be room for an age change. There are some of us who actually use this as an example of why transgenderism is bad logic. In fact, there are videos that some of us have cut in which we ask this exact question. So good for this guy, because I love it. The court said there would be practical problems. This is so good. Okay, so the judge said he had some sympathy with Mr. Radelbein, as people could now change their gender, which would have once been unthinkable. But the court said there'd be practical problems in allowing people to change their birth date, as it would mean legally deleting part of their lives. Oh, you mean like legally deleting the part of your life where you were biologically male, as in your entire life, if you're a transgender female? Or legally deleting even the part of your life where you identified as a member of the other gender? The judge asked Mr. Radelbein about the status of his early years from 1949 to 1969 if his official birth date was put back. He said, for whom did your parents care in those years? Who was that little boy back then? The judge asked. The court is going to deliver a ruling on it. And the answer is, who cares? Right? Shouldn't that be the woke answer? The woke answer is, who cares? Your parents cared for it. We're just rewriting history now. So if you were a little boy growing up and now you think that you are a woman, were your parents caring for a little boy? No, because we can change your birth certificate. So they're apparently caring for a little girl. You were always a little girl. So if you say that you are actually 20 years younger than you are, then your parents were caring for nothing. You didn't exist. It was all a figment of the imagination. I love this story so much. I should have put it in things I like. It's just, I've decided. It is too wonderful in every possible respect. Good on that Dutch man for being so woke.